Walmart FLW Tour descended onto Lewis Smith Lake in northern Alabama with an unbounded sense of optimism. These bass were as active as you would expect during the early spring, and you could catch a 5-fish limit, throwing just about anything.
I've got confidence in the area I'm in, and I'm just going to keep fishing.
I've seen schools of 10 5-pounders just swim into a pocket.
About a 3 or 4 pounder right there. It's a real good sign. Talk about a call.
Lewis Smith is a river impoundment that fingers out from the dam at the southern end. With over 500 miles of shoreline, this deep, skinny lake provides plenty of habitat for both spotted and largemouth bass. The spotted bass were moving onto slightly deeper beds to begin their annual spawn, while the largemouth were holding in shallower water.
These fish, you know, they started off at the beginning of the week, they were 10 feet or so away from the bed. I could see the bed, the fish were sitting way off away from it. Today, they were actually leaving the bed.
They like to get in cover a whole lot tighter. They like to get in buck brush, a lay down, under a dock. They like something extra.
You're seeing a lot more of those largemouth in the backs of the pockets, around the bushes, shallower docks. Kind of more of their normal haunts, places that they want to be that are shallow where they can ambush. They're not in open water running bait as much as a spotted bass would.
While technology has greatly impacted bass fishing tournaments over the past few years, with advanced electronics now being the standard on most professional boats, the real revolution has come with the innovations in web connectivity that can be used to bring coverage of an event to anyone with access to the internet. FLW's web team revamped the way tournaments would be covered in 2015 with an eye to capturing all the natural beauty while providing near real-time updates to the fans.
Typically we put out 20 ions a day, and that way we just kind of have a good round footage so that we might have somebody that went deep, we might have somebody that went shallow, but we just kind of get a little bit of everything. And at the end of the day, when we get all the footage in, I usually put together like a highlight video or something like that. You know what people want nowadays, it's instant feedback. It's what are guys doing right now. So it's awesome that we get to put this out on the internet very quickly. It's usually the night or the next day. So they get to see these guys, especially this week, they're gonna be catching fish off of beds and we're gonna get some really good footage.
When we talked to him yesterday, John said, "You better put an ion on my boat because I'm gonna catch him." You asked and you received.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
I'm going to stop it on there real quick.
Okay.
All right.
Sounds good. We've got a new website now, and it's really more conducive to more current content. So more headline stories, more videos, more photos. And it kind of goes back to sort of incorporating social media into our actual website.
Last time at Toho, we got Shane Lahee's big bass. That was awesome. So I'm hoping today we get a killer, like, bedding fish catch. It's going to be awesome.
We're going to get a lot of fish catches.
Yeah.
We've got about half a dozen people on the water at most tournaments, and then we've got our crew of on the water reporters who are sending back all the updates that you see on the website. And then Rob Newell's also out there, and his primary job is to start formulating the headlines for the evening story. You know, we've got a couple people who are primarily focused on photography.
There's five of us out here, you know, trying to cover 154 pros. Average guy, you're probably shooting 1,000 photos or more in 5 hours on the water.
On the first day, you have to follow everybody a little bit and see who's gonna catch them. But on subsequent days, we can dial in a little more. And I fished in college and in tournaments, and I made two FLW national championships. And I didn't really imagine doing this as a career, but it's about as good as it gets.
You start getting photos that you think are interesting enough to actually go up on the web. We usually just Dropbox stuff back from out here on the lake. By 9 o'clock, we usually like to have a few shots up and you know, a bunch of tweets by then.
When I'm thumbing through a bunch of photos at the same time, we kind of look for action in the front deck to symbolize something that's going on there. And then once we see action on the front deck, I kind of go a little bit slower to check for splashes and hook sets and cast shots and that type of thing. For the website, everybody wants to get to be one of the lead images for one of our headline stories throughout the day.
As the second day of the tournament drew to a close, it became clear that the headline story for the web was going to be the hot hand of rookie pro Zack Birge.
18 pounds, 15 ounces, give him a big round of applause.
The young man from Oklahoma, just barely out of college, was busy establishing himself as a major player in the upper echelon of the sport.
First time in the top 10 in the tournament, so I'm just going fishing. Whatever happens, happens. I've got huge shoes to fill, being 23, and these guys, you know, most of them are 30s and 40s or so. They've been doing this for a long time. For me to be in that position, it's sinking in, it's kind of surreal. It's awesome.
This is a super deep, crystal clear lake, known for catching big spotted bass. I love catching big spots. I enjoy doing it, but it's not something that I'm awesome at. And after practice, I went with what I was good at, and I went shallow and I stayed in the bushes. I made that work for me.
That was me about 8 years ago. Except my boat was only 8 foot.
In the mouth. Took long enough. I'll take him.
I probably burned closer to 200 gallons of fuel in practice, just running, just looking at creeks, looking where brush was, keying in on the areas that have more cover. And so that's what I did. I didn't do a whole lot of fishing. I did a lot of looking. But at the same time, I'd pull into one that looked awesome and I'd fish. And if I caught one, I'd mark it and I went back to it in the tournament. But my two key areas are on the east arm of the lake, and you know, they've had fish both days. I haven't had to leave them.
In the mouth. Looks like there might be a bed right back there.
There he is.
Got the boat. Got no help to call.
Going out this morning, it was real cold. It'd been cold all night. I didn't know really how the fish would react to it. Caught one on a frog right off the bat, and that keyed me in on, yeah, they'll still eat it even though it's cold. Throughout the rest of the day, I caught a couple fish on beds, a couple here and there on this and that, but I picked up a buzzbait late in the day.
Big one.
Once it got to that time, and they bit.
Got him that time.
Right here on this point, just caught one over five.
I'm done for the day.
They've been watching the Twitter feed all day. I'm sure that makes them feel better.
14 pounds, 15 ounces, 15 pounds, 10 ounces, 17 pounds, and 5 ounces.
You know, I just want to get through, make top 10 tomorrow, and then that's when I'll go out and I'll, you know, try to bring back as big a bag as I can.
New leader. 17 pounds and 11 ounces. He's caught 3 days in a row. Big time, let's go. Let's see your two best bass.
With his biggest bites coming shallow and late in the day, Zack Birge not only held his lead, but extended it going into the final day. But a major cold front was on the way that could shut that bite down. The final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Lewis Smith Lake is next. The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Walmart. Save money, live better. Mercury Marine, number one on the water. Ranger Boats, still building legends, one at a time. Find, navigate, dominate with Lowrance. Motor Guide. Trolling motors engineered for top anglers. And by, you can get more from your oil with Quaker State. It's a cold morning for the top 10 anglers who made it to the final day of the Walmart FLW Tour. Veteran angler Tracy Adams is making a small adjustment, knowing the bedfish won't be active before the sun gets higher in the sky.
I'm heading out here this morning, try to catch a limit early and then probably hunt beds as long as the sun will stay up. Hopefully it will.
This is the first top 10 I've made since I had a heart attack back in May. And when we take off and blast off across that smooth lake today, yeah, I mean, it's going to be a feeling like I hadn't had in a long time, and I really look forward to that.
Looks like it's going to be pretty bright and sunny, light winds. So,
if it goes as it should, it'll be a 12 to 3 window again where I put my main weight in the boat.
Rookie pro Zack Birge is keeping a cool head, waiting for the afternoon sun to trigger his bite. It's a daunting task to hold off this many veteran sticks on the final day. With only 8 hours to bring back their best five, you can be sure the veterans are not waiting for a bite, but are scrambling to make something happen now.
Game time, let's do it.
Here we go, man. Let's do this.
The good thing is we're 8 pounds behind, so there's really, you know, it takes a lot of pressure off when you're not sitting 2 pounds back. And we're up in Rock Creek quite a ways back. There's three major feeder creeks that kind of join together, and that's the region that we're in. They like these underspins. This is a fish head. A fairly big one, a 1/2 ounce, you know, but I'm trying to keep it kind of high in the water column. Fishing over 80 feet of water, but the bait's probably not even going 5 feet down. Touched it.
Got him.
There's one. See how fat those things are? I mean, that is one healthy fish. Not as big as I've been catching here, but I promise you, it makes me feel a lot better. Fish number one.
Dave Lefebvre has been able to use this tactic each morning to get a solid limit in the boat. One vet in this top 10 who is fishing with a lot of confidence is Clark Windlett. He's focusing on a stretch of the lake that he feels is replenishing every day.
My thought all along in this tournament is that if I throw this big bait, throwing a big swim jig with a big trailer on it, if I throw it the whole time, I can catch some big ones on it. And, you know, I have sight fish some, and if I just can stay with this, you know, I caught a 5.11 the second day, I caught a 4.5 yesterday. There's got to be a couple of them that'll bite it. Get in here. That fish, absolutely, I cannot believe he went ahead and bit that bait. He came up there, I mean, literally hit it with a foot of line out. That's a good 2.5 pounder anyway. That's a start, but it's a little late for a good start. I need bigger fish quick. But I'm pretty happy about that one. I just kept, what I did was is I actually quit reeling, because what happened was is I couldn't reel anymore. I had this much line out, so I just kept pulling my bait, and he came up there and bit it.
Clark might be calming down a little bit, but the tension for fishing for over $100,000 amplifies every decision. What bait to use, what part of the lake to concentrate on, these factors are constantly banging around in the angler's mind. Scott Martin and Drew Bitten both decided to start their day, not just in the same creek, but throwing at the same dock. And Scott Martin is not happy about Drew's decision.
I'm so mad right now, dude. That's not cool.
Well, come up here and fish beside me. I don't mind.
You're sitting right where I need to be sitting, dude.
I'm telling you. I know I seen them all yesterday right there.
You saw me here in practice. I fished here yesterday morning till 9:30, 10 o'clock. You're going down the bank, dude. I mean, you were back there in that pocket, dude.
I know. I started there earlier. I thought I was going to have it to myself, but I was headed here.
That's where I've been fishing.
Just chill out and fish, Scott.
Well, you're sitting right where I want to cast, dude. I make casts in that dock. I make casts in that gut, all right in this little zone, and you're casting across.
About had enough.
This isn't the way to start a tournament, dude. Final day of the tournament, and you come in here and you're casting all across where I'm casting. You hadn't even fished here, dude.
Scott, I did fish here.
When, yesterday afternoon?
I fished here the second morning, too.
You didn't, dude.
Yeah, I did.
Not right here, you did not.
Scott, I come in here at about 10 o'clock, second morning.
Come on, man.
I'm not keeping you from catching any fish here.
You got me madder than hell, dude.
Well, calm down and fish. You're a good fisherman. Calm down and fish.
So I just wait for you to get your bait in, then I can cast?
I'm casting to the left where you're casting. I'm not going to cast over your line. I'm not an idiot.
So if I ask your partner if y'all fished here, he's gonna tell me y'all fished right here by this little rock right here in the middle of the deal.
I promise you.
Yeah.
I'm not keeping you from catching them today, so just calm down. We got plenty of time to fish.
It's just not how it works, dude.
All right, Scott, it's yours. I ain't gonna sit here and argue with you about it. I don't do well with crybabies.
I ain't crying, I'm just mad as hell.
You're a crybaby.
No, I'm mad as hell, dude. It's the last day of the tournament, that's where I fished yesterday. And then you pull in here like it's yours, you're sitting dead right where my boat's sitting. I wonder why he didn't, when I was catching him yesterday, why didn't he come in here and say, dude, this is where I've been fishing too. Well, I'm catching them. Why didn't he come over here and fish? Why did he just keep on going down the bank throwing at bushes? Oh, but then the last day of the tournament, you want to come start on it and sit your boat right at it and cast exactly where I'm casting and act like, oh, that's where I've been fishing. You're a liar, dude. $125,000 will make you do some weird stuff. Some people don't know how to deal with it, I guess.
Scott Martin claims his turf, but now he needs to settle down and fish. It's a cold morning in Alabama, but the action of the Walmart FLW Tour is heating things up. It's a clear, cold morning on Lewis Smith Lake. For the young rookie who is leading the Walmart FLW Tour, the conditions couldn't be any worse. His shallow water bite needs air temperatures above freezing and some cloud cover. With neither of those factors in his favor, he's yet to catch a fish.
Optimal conditions for me would have been lows staying in the 50s and the highs getting, 60, 65 or so. But it dipped down to 27, 28 last night. It got pretty chilly.
What I think's really happening is that those fish are just locked down in the bed. They're deep, real deep. You can't see them.
I saw one over there yesterday and I couldn't get it to bite. I thought maybe if I stayed way back off of it, I could get him going. I don't know.
There's two types of bait fish in this lake, herring, which are a little bit bigger, but there's all these little small minnows, and I really think that's what they're feeding on here for the most part, are these small little minnows. So you have to have something that's kind of matched the hatch, small little bait. Like I've got here, this is a tiny little grub, a little boot tail swim bait.
The key to this tournament, I think, adapting to the conditions. We've had a lot thrown at us, starting going back on Sunday when we had monsoon. We had 30 degree weather this morning and we've had it in the 80s. Little guy. Definitely not what we need to win. If I don't call these, I don't have a chance to win. But it's fish anyway.
Dave Lefebvre seems to have the hot hand this morning and gets right back to work. Meanwhile, Jason Reyes is not far from the launch, working a small deep cove up the Bear Creek branch of the lake.
There's probably 100 3-pounders swimming in here right now. It's one of those deals where if everybody could catch 15 pounds worth of spots, it'd be done, but they're kind of ghosts. They just show up, and when they do, the guy that's around them gets right, and if you're not around them, you catch 12 pounds, 10 pounds.
There's one. Yeah. That's the kind right there. Just living out here in the 60 foot of water. Catch five of those, I might be players. I've been sight fishing a little bit. I've been throwing a wacky worm under real deep docks, just kind of throwing it in there and letting it, catching those suspended fish and ones that are moving up, getting ready to spawn. That's been pretty much it. That's pretty much how I caught them all week. I just go by and see them and I just try to keep going, just mark where they're at. Going up, turn around and come back, kind of stay back and work them, and most of them are biting.
Does take a lot of patience on these bedding fish here. Some of them bite pretty easy. Yesterday I couldn't get him, he wouldn't stay in the bed.
I'm fishing down here pretty close to takeoff, but I kind of think you could run this pattern all over the lake. I'm using a Zoom centipede worm,
watermelon seed, and the wacky worm, I'm using a Zoom trick worm watermelon seed. So watermelon seed definitely seemed like the color this week for me anyway.
Come on, babe. You ain't that big. We'll take you. We'll take you for now.
All right, we're on board. Just gotta get bigger.
My goodness, that the fish is here. I'm gonna win the tournament right here. You always keep your eyes open on these herring lakes. It can happen like this.
Drew Benton left the water that Scott Martin claimed, and now the pro from Florida finds himself right in the middle of an extremely active school of bass.
Number one.
See, that's what happens when you're lighthearted about things and you don't get in arguments. You come into a place and they start schooling around your boat.
Little spots are stingy this morning. They feel like they really want to eat either. It's funny, I've caught at least like three fish right here every time I've come by. The water temperature's showing 56 here. A couple days ago, before it started getting cold at night, it was in the afternoons, this was actually like 64 degrees. Kind of waiting around for that late bite for my largemouth to start eating. The water temperature keeps dropping every day, so my window gets smaller and smaller. I'm just trying to catch a couple little Kentuckys real quick.
Boy, took long enough.
Is this first keeper a sign that Zack has located some fish, or will he keep playing the waiting game, waiting for the water temperature to rise?
Little limit. Who knows, I might have the lead for a minute.
They might be little, but right now Dave LaFebre is the only pro with a five bass limit in his boat that's moved him up the leaderboard quickly and got him thinking about one thing.
But I've been doing this a long time. I want to win. I'm probably going to leave these fish biting because they're all kind of running that same pound and a half size. I'm just going to give it a few more minutes and then go spend the rest of the day, you know, targeting big fish. That's the one thing about having a limit. You know, 90% of this game is mental, and it makes you feel, you know, it just makes you feel a little bit better. My starting spot this morning, I started on it the last 2 days, and, you know, I was just going in there to try to catch two or three spots. That's my mindset. You know, I want to catch two or three. You know, the ones I've been catching here have been 3 pounds plus, so I know they're still here. Give it a little bit longer. And they were biting pretty good, so I ended up staying. Just try to get more than just two. You know, I might as well just catch a few. I've been leaving them biting every day. Today's the last day. No sense in leaving them. So I just sat there, and I'm not real sure how many I caught, but I, you know, at least 12, 15, maybe even 20. I caught quite a few. Got a decent limit. There's probably 100 fish right here, no doubt, around that dock. It calms you down when you have a limit already that quick. And the way that I'm fishing later, you know, it's a long time between bites. So it's a... It was a good feeling. That one helps a little bit. See, I can weigh that one in with 3 6-pounders. That one and the other one and be okay.
Got it. Oh my gosh, dude! Dang it, dude, I had him! This spot here is a classic staging spot. What it is, we've got a main creek arm off the main lake. If you look at your map, it comes in here and it does a couple little S-turns right back here in the back. So I'm sitting on this little point and the creek channel swings against those docks and comes back around. And where I'm sitting is about 12 foot of water. And it's 50 and 60 foot around that turn. These spotted bass are staging on this point, and as the herring and the bait fish swim through, they come up and pin them up against the bank and against this point and feed on them. It's the last bit of deep water into this main creek. Big one. Big one. Big one. Big fish, dude. It's a gigantic fish, man. Got him! Bingo! That's the kind of spots we're looking for right there, guys. Look at that fish, dude. That's the kind of spots are on Smith Lake. Now, I've made an adjustment. I hadn't caught him on a drop shot. All week been drop shotting little worms. I put that little tiny swim bait on the drop shot, and they ate it. I might have figured something out.
Scott's 5-pounder is certainly enough to get him excited. People get excited for lots of reasons when they come to this part of northern Alabama. Jasper is rich in history, with a charming downtown full of shops. The main attraction this week has been the FLW Outdoor Expo, which gives fans a chance to meet some of the top pros and also sample some tasty barbecue that meets the demanding standards of these anglers.
I got two fish. One of them's a pretty nice one, 2.5-pounder. The other one's just barely a keeper, no good at all. I really don't know what to do any different. I really feel like I've got to keep throwing that bait. And I'm going to end up side fishing some. I just got to throw it in front of the right fish at the right time, and if I do, I'll catch some big ones.
The unique thing for me in this tournament is that I'm actually fishing two different patterns. I'm fishing suspended fish, and I'm able to sight fish every once in a while if I find one on a bed, but I'm doing it in the exact same areas.
And I mean, I should have caught him that first cast. I knew he would bite quick, but I mean, he was just cruising out with it when I flipped it in there. You know, he bit when I first pitched it in there. He swims back up there and he's just all spooky. I'm thinking, well, heck, I'm gonna have a hard time catching that fish now. I'm sitting there shaking that thing and he goes over there and I couldn't even see him bite it. It just goes, boom. Okay, getting that. Not a great big one, but. That's number three, a little over 2 pounds.
The sight fishing is starting to turn on as the sun climbs. And over on the east end of the lake, the higher sun should be precisely what Zack Birge needs, but the water temperature is still a bit on the cool side.
I haven't seen any fish yet, but yesterday I caught my first big one about now, and I just picked up from there as the day went on. Water's warming up, almost 2 degrees already since we first pulled in here. Fish ought to come right with them. Number two, ain't a big one. Don't look in there, there's not enough weight yet.
The quality bites continue to elude Zack Birge, while Dave LaFebre has moved from his hot morning spot and is settling in on the hunt for bigger fish.
I made some questionable calls today in my own mind, and I know what has been happening. I was trying to adapt with the day. I didn't want to get stuck into what I did yesterday. And so after I caught those spots, I wanted to just go try something different. I hit a place on the way back in yesterday and caught a 3.5-pounder and called on my last cast. And I decided to go back to that spot and explore it. And, you know, that one was on a buzzbait yesterday. So I put that Terminator buzzbait back on, same exact one, went in there and spent probably 3 hours. I could be way, way wrong, but I'm pretty bold to say that whoever wins, it's gonna be anybody in the top 10, it could be 10th place, but there's gonna be a massive mega bag. I think it's gonna be whoever catches that, you know, that 22 plus, that's what I think is gonna happen. I mean, nobody's safe.
LaFebre's game plan is working perfectly as he upgrades his limit. And the man who started 6 places back has now taken the lead.
What he does is he runs in there and he bites it so fast, I can't even I can't even react to set the hook.
Man, we need to find a big one, what we need.
Sight fishing master, the whole universe is back in business.
A little frustrating today because I broke off twice already. I haven't broke off all week.
The final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Lewis Smith Lake has been the story of ups and downs. Zack Birge started off the day with a 3-pound lead and has now fallen to 4th place. while Dave Lefebvre has been on fire and moved from seventh place to sit atop the standings. He's having an almost flawless day on the water, and it's erasing the bad memories of the last few tournaments.
This year and last year, you know, it's been a real bummer for me. I finished almost last in last year and in the 80s this year. So, I got a little hole to dig out of, but the Forestwood Cup is, that's the pinnacle of what we do. I've never missed it. I've never sat at home for any championship in my life, you know, any championship. And to know that the guys are out there fishing and I'm sitting at home, it was just, it's a feeling that I needed to have, you know, to feel it. I don't want that to happen again.
Dave's buzzbait connects yet again on another good keeper and an upgrade in overall weight of about a pound. Clark Windlett is also looking for a fish over 3 pounds, and the sight fishing master thinks he may have found one. His ability to read the fish's mood is second to none.
You know, sight fishing is just a lot about just watching and waiting and trying to gauge the mood of the fish. And what happens so often is, you know, that fish is just, you know, he doesn't want to pay any mind at all. And he, you know, but you just got to kind of decipher, and based on a lot of it's based on experience, just if a fish will bite or not. Missed him. And a lot of times, you know, it'll take 5-10 minutes messing with it. Well, you know, you start thinking about it, and you know, you spend 10 minutes, you think it'll bite, you spend 30, all of a sudden you got 40 minutes into the fish, then you lose it. He bit it there, but he just won't eat it. I mean, you can get in a bad roll sight fishing really quick, but you can get in a good roll too. You know, you can pull up, find a big one, and then, you know, 5 yards down the bank, there's another big one. And so it's just one of those things that can pay off, but it can be tough too. In the mouth. Gosh, you were hard to catch. I lost him first thing, almost about a 2 3/4. I lost him first thing. I weeded that bed, and it's a good fish, though. Number 4.
Trying to win a 4-day tournament is hard in any sport, but perhaps bass fishing is the most challenging of all. The lake changes daily. The fish you bite one day can get lockjaw the next. That realization may be why Zack Birge is keeping things positive.
It's my rookie year, so I don't have a lot of experience. I've always wanted to fish professionally, and I know there's a million people out there that do. You know, I've stuck with it, and I've put all my eggs in one basket. And coming up through college and the Rayovac series, and you know, just gradually improving myself and moving forward, it's. You know, got me to where I am today. And you may not win them all, but you can still do good and cash a check. To me, cashing a check, being a rookie, is more important than winning. I'm here just to be able to set myself up financially to do it again next year.
A 12-incher, but barely.
Zack, he's came in here and he's lit it up the last couple years, and he's just got to ride that momentum and get all he can get out of it. You know, once you get the ball rolling, a lot of times you can keep it rolling for a while, so he just needs to keep going with it as long as he can.
Solid advice from someone who's been in this sport for over 15 years. Tracy Adams was also counting on the sun to warm up his bite, but that has yet to happen.
So far, it's not going as well as I'd planned it. I'm having trouble not finding very many off the beds. I've saw like 2 or 3 all day. So I think I'm gonna give it just a little while longer, and I may probably just switch over to just fishing docks only. Hey, he's bigger than I thought he was. Yeah, he'll help. He'll help. Yeah, that's a little bit of an upgrade.
We switched up a little bit throwing that swim bait, and I come back over here to this, you know, stretch of rocks throwing a shaky head. I've been kind of doing that when I'm not getting bit on that swim bait. just to pick up some fish, but I've caught some nice ones doing this, so finally caught one. Oh, come on in. Get in here. That'll work. That'll work. It's a good one, too. Old jammer.
A limit is hard to come by if your name isn't Dave, but the weights are also starting to tighten up as the final hours of the Walmart FLW Tour are winding down. The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by BRP Evinrude. Experience the power of choice at ChooseYourETech.com. Rayovac, power for the always on you. Minn Kota, anywhere, anytime. Always Smooth, Keystone Light Beer, the only beer of FLW. Power Pole, swift, silent, secure. And by Igloo. Get out, stay out.
Come on up in here. It's a good one. Look how good he ate it though. That one was a long time coming. When you struggle, everyone counts.
Yeah! Boom! 4-pound spot, baby. How you like me now?
What happened to him? It's like they disappeared.
Zack Burge's day started slow and just never picked up from there. The leaderboard is now a tight race between two longtime veterans, Clark Wendlandt, who is a three-time Angler of the Year on the Walmart FLW Tour, is trailing Dave LaFebvre by the thinnest of margins.
I had some freedom because these fish don't bite. You know, some of the other guys were saying they bite 11, 12 o'clock. It was really a lot later for me. So I just felt like I had that buffer zone, you know, like I could try some different stuff in the area.
Dave LaFebvre has one more ace up his sleeve on this day when he can do no wrong. With less than an hour to go, he is throwing a waking bait at banks that the blueback herring have been spawning on. Meanwhile, Jason Reyes is hoping he can find a pattern that will be more effective than the sight fishing he's relied on so far.
Let's see if some docks will pay off for us.
The increased cloud cover late in the day has made the sight fishing difficult. And so now Jason is going to throw in the backs of docks.
I'm throwing over this cable. There's a little gut coming in here with a little row of bushes on the inside, and they're shallow, but it's 20, 31 feet deep where I'm setting with my trolling motor. So it makes kind of like a little funnel right there. There might be a little wolf pack of them up by them bushes. Then I gotta worry about getting them around that cable. I got them on that time. Got them over the cable. Yep. Right. That's a good one. That's a jammer Smith Lake spot right there. That's gonna help us.
Yeah, I just spotted a big one on a bed. You know, I've decided at this point that, you know, all I can do is just fish. And so as I'm going down the bank, though, I keep looking and got in this little cut. There's a pretty nice one sitting right over here. Only problem with it is that it's gonna be real hard to get to.
The truth of the matter is that I'm sight fishing a little bit, but I only caught one bass in the first 2 days that I knew where it was before the tournament started. So all the looking I did pretty much was just wasted. I didn't do any good at all.
Gosh, dunk it.
That stinks.
Then I just finally made the decision, I'm just gonna go fishing, and I ended up seeing some different fish. And I realized that there was very, very few on beds when the tournament started. After yesterday, I determined there's quite a few more spawning now.
Oh. Man, that one will call.
Did Clark Winlett just gain enough weight to knock off Dave LaFebvre? The final weigh-in of the Walmart FLW Tour on Lewis Smith Lake is next. It's time for one last cast. As the top 10 pros of the Walmart FLW Tour prepare to make their way back in.
Well, that's about all she wrote.
You know, I don't really know that I really made any wrong decisions. I think the fish were leaving the beds or not quite as many on the beds. And I just stayed with the area I was in, and I'll just look forward to the next one right now.
The fishing on Lewis Smith Lake was good, but not good enough for anyone to overtake Zack Birge's lead until the reigning Angler of the Year took to the stage.
Andy Morgan, in 3 days, amassed 45 pounds and 13 ounces. New leader, 13 pounds and 13 ounces.
I made some questionable calls today in my own mind, but I know what has been happening. I was trying to adapt with the day. I didn't want to get stuck into what I did yesterday. You know, I skipped some docks today, which I haven't done. Fished a little bit of bank, you know, just did some different things, and it worked. I needed it. I needed every single one that I caught.
A big five bass limit today for Dave LaFebvre, worth 19 pounds and 5 ounces. You're the new leader. Wow!
I didn't even think I had a prayer. I thought I needed 2 more 6-pounders, if that puts it a little bit better into perspective. I mean, it just blows my mind. I just can't believe it.
You're sitting right where I need to be sitting, dude.
Scott Martin started his morning with a showdown over a dock between he and Drew Benton. But he showed veteran poise in putting that behind him.
I had a good tournament. I did what I like to do, which is sight fish, caught some fish deep, so it was fun. We'll see what happens. Hopefully I'll get a good check.
He has a limit of bass worth 14 pounds and 3 ounces. Scott moves you to second place with 60 pounds and 12 ounces.
Stringer after stringer comes to the scales. All good limits, but none of them good enough to overtake Dave LaFebvre's 19-pound day. After Drew Benton falls short, there is one man yet to weigh in who is within striking distance. Clark Winlett has the steely composure of a veteran as he takes the stage.
You know, I had a lot of bites today. You know, when you're throwing a swim bait, it's kind of a feast or famine bait. And, you know, I mean, we got 3 days after a cold front. It's 28 degrees, 30 degrees yesterday morning, so it's cold. And those fish just weren't committing to bite the bait as well as they had been. And they'd hit it. I'd even see them sometimes. It looked like they had their mouth closed around it, but they just weren't getting it.
I can tell you it's going to be close. You got 5 good ones in there. You need 14-8 to take the lead from Dave LaFebvre. A limit worth 12 pounds and 10 ounces. 12 pounds and 10 ounces. One of the legends in the game, Leander, Texas pro Clark Winlett. He moves up to second place. And so now we've got one pro left, and Dave LaFebvre sitting on top. Number 4, all right. Number 5, let's see the kicker.
That's it.
4 today worth 5 pounds and 2 ounces. Your champion is Dave LaFebvre.
It was all about adjusting throughout the tournament. I caught the majority of the fish that I caught on a bait that I never even dreamed I would throw. That was the key for me.
LaFebvre's best day on the water came when it mattered most. And coming back from an 8-pound deficit means this victory might be one of his most memorable. From here, the tour heads to Beaver Lake in Arkansas, one of the toughest fisheries in the country. Be sure to watch all the action on the next FLW.